In this video, we're going to take a look at the best solutions to the most important thing that I want you to make sure you have implemented on your website, and that is to have a reliable backup solution. But I'm going to talk about some of the things that you want to consider when choosing a backup solution. We're going to talk about some of these backup solutions as well. Best thing is none of these are actually going to cost anything. They do have some premium features if you wanted, but you don't need them. We're going to talk about that in this video. Hi, my name is Adam from WPCrafter.com, where I make WordPress tutorial videos for non-techies. If you're new here, consider clicking on the subscribe button. If you don't want to miss a thing, click on the little bell off to the right. I'm happy to have you in this video because this is something I'm very passionate about, is making sure you have a reliable backup, because there are so many problems that you may face with your WordPress website that if you just had a backup, and not just had a backup, but you had a backup that you knew how to restore, then so many of these problems you just wouldn't even have to deal with. Perfect example. Last month, there was someone in my Facebook group that was having a problem with their website where it got hacked into because there were some out-of-date plugins, and it would have been so much easier to get him back in business if he had a reliable update. And so that's what I want to talk about in this video. Now, if you go to WordPress, the WordPress directory, and do a search for the word backup, there are quite a few solutions, and I've used most of them. So in this video, I want to talk about the things to look for in a backup plugin. So first of all, number one, you want a backup plugin that you can automatically schedule backups to happen every so often. So this would be maybe make a backup every once a week or every day or something along those lines. That's criteria number one of a good backup solution. Number two thing that you want to look at is, does it back up off-site? So what this means is most of your web hosting companies, they don't want you storing backups on the hosting account. And if you don't have a backup solution that allows you to, say, once the backup happens, push it off to Dropbox or something like that, they could get a little bit upset. And plus, if something was to happen to your web hosting account, you wouldn't want your backups there anyway, because then you wouldn't have access to it. So you really want a backup solution that's going to push those backups to something like Dropbox or something along those lines. Number three, things that you want to consider is you also want a backup solution that will automatically delete old backups. So if you don't have this feature and the backup plugin just keeps making backups, a year later you've forgotten about it, and next thing you know, it's taking up gigabytes and gigabytes of storage space, and it becomes a real big problem. Some web hosting companies will actually kick you off their service if you do that. Now, the last thing that I think you really want to consider with choosing a backup solution is, how easy is it really to restore a backup? And this is one of those features that I noticed there's some discrepancies. Some of these solutions are very hard to actually do the restore. It's not so simple. So those are the criteria that I have for choosing a backup solution after having used WordPress for many years, tried many of these solutions. I've learned what you want to be looking for, and I want to talk about some of the solutions that do meet this criteria, and let's just jump in. So if you were on the WordPress directory and you searched for backup, or if you're in WordPress, you go to plugins, add new, and do a search for backup, the first result is updrafts. Now, updrafts, I'm just going to cut to the chase, is I think the very best well-rounded backup solution for WordPress. There's a free version and there's a paid version. The free version gets you everything that you need. It meets all of the criteria that I've spelled out. In fact, I'll put a link in the video description box to a video that I created last year on how to install and configure updrafts, based upon everything I just said, pushing the backups up to Dropbox and to make sure that backups get automatically deleted after a certain period of time. It meets all of that criteria. Now, here is Updrafts right here. It's fantastic. Definitely, if you don't have a backup solution, consider jumping into Updrafts. It's what I'm using actually on all of my websites. Now, there's another solution that I want to make you aware of, and it's kind of different. It's called WP Time Capsule, and what they're doing is they're really backing everything up on your website, but what's neat is it allows you to do a rollback. So if you wanted to roll back a day or roll back before you did this update or some kind of period of time in the last 30 days, this has this automatic rollback feature. Another nice thing about WP Time Capsule is that when it goes to make a backup, it doesn't back everything up all over again, zip it, and then now you're taking up double the space and it just becomes this very large repository of backups. What this does is it just backs up what's changed in your database, if you created a new post, whatever's changed as far as a plugin or a theme getting updated. All it does is back up what has changed. I really think that qualifies it as the smartest backup solution that will have the least amount of impact on your web hosting account. So typically when a backup process is going, it's going to eat up a lot of resources, but that's not really the case here with WP Time Capsule, because it's just looking for changes and it's just backing up those changes that have occurred. I've been using this as well since it came out last year. I think it was in March. So I've been using it almost 12 months. Now I have the paid version of this, which gives me some additional features, which is it has this feature where I can automatically, with one click of a mouse, create an entire staging environment to test updates, and then I can delete it or push it back to the live site. Full disclosure, I did run into some problems with that last year, and I worked with the developer and he apologized and it helped make his plugin better. But the developer of this is a really great guy. He's got a ton of experience and he's got several companies that serve WordPress, and one of them is Infinite WP, which is an all-in-one management solution for WordPress. So these deeper technical things he really knows. Now, the reason I'm actually talking about this is because the paid version of this are going to be releasing a feature hopefully in a few months, and I'm excited about it. And what it's going to do is it's going to take snapshots before and after updates on your website. So this is a problem that I have been running into a lot lately, where there's an update available for a plugin and then I'm a good WordPress user. I update the plugin and I'm not looking at every page on my website. And then later on, I'll find out that plugin I updated, now something looks different on the front end of my website because maybe it's poorly coded or there is a problem that the developer didn't realize when they pushed out the update. And I'm the one stuck with a website that looks like a little funky. So they're going to be rolling out a feature that I'm sold as soon as it comes out. It's going to take a snapshot before, a snapshot after. If it notices that something significant visually has changed, it'll roll back that update and notify me, which I think is going to be huge. I'll definitely be talking about and demonstrating that feature as soon as it is released. But this is one of the things that I'm pretty excited about. Now, that won't be in the free version because it's going to be very server resource intensive. However, if you have a website that receives a decent enough traffic and you want to make sure all your bases are covered at all times, that's definitely going to be something you want to look into. Another plugin that has got a very large user base, but I don't like it, is Duplicator. And the reason I don't, okay, so this is going to be more powerful in some regards than Updrafts, right? Because you also have a migration feature in this. And this is something you don't get out of the free version of Updrafts. But the problem is, if you want to restore a backup or you want to do a migration, you have to manually log into your server and to upload files and FTP and all that. And it just becomes a little on the tedious side. And that's why I don't like Duplicator. I'm sure it works fabulous, but because of that one issue, I think it's more trouble to restore. And that's what I talked about early in the criteria, is how easy is it to restore your backup? And as far as that goes, Duplicator, it's not so easy. And this is also one of the problems I have with one of the most well-known paid backup solutions called Backup Buddy, is when you actually want to restore a Backup Buddy backup, you have to upload files to the server via FTP. Most people don't even know what FTP is, have an FTP program, or know their FTP login. It's just foreign language. And that's why I think that solutions like Duplicator are ones that you should definitely avoid. Lastly, I actually just noticed this. I want to try this out. It's Backup and Restore to Dropbox. This looks easy. Looks interesting if you can do free migrations. Although for migrations, I use all-in-one migration anyway. So anyways, I'm going to put a link in the video description box on number one on how to the video for updrafts. I'm going to put a link to the video for WP Time Capsule, and some of these other ones I'm going to have dedicated videos reviewing and walking through the features on them. But I think those are definitely the top two that you should be using. They're the ones that I've used, and they have never let me down as far as the backup function of them goes. So I want to hear what you are using for backup, or even if you have a backup, and I want to strongly encourage you to make sure you have a backup. But in the video description box, tell me what backup solution you are using and why. So hey, thanks for watching this video, and I'll see you in the next one.